I walked into our briefing of the P20, I thought that we'd just get a smaller, watered-down version of the Mate 10 Pro as Huawei usually does, but as it turns out, that's not entirely accurate. One of these phones is pretty much that, but then the other is something else entirely. With Anton Dinaj in Paris, I'm Jaime Rivera with Pocket Now, and let's talk about the Huawei P20 and P20 Pro. Let's start with the obvious. Both the new Huawei P20 and P20 Pro look very much alike at first glance. We have the same notch at the top that I'm sure you're gonna butcher in the comments, and the same fingerprint scanner that serves as navigation gestures at the bottom. You flip them from the back and the same reflective glass finish is here on both, with color options that range from black, midnight blue, pink gold, and twilight, which everyone here being briefed really liked. Even features like the Kirin 970 processor with MPU are the same across the board, but then the similarities pretty much end there. The P20 Pro has 2 more gigs of RAM, and it sports a larger battery at 4000 mAh versus 3400, and is IP67 water and dust resistant versus IP53. The Pro even has an IR blaster, which the P20 doesn't have. The P20 Pro also has a larger 6.1-inch Full HD Plus OLED versus the P20's LCD, even if it's really hard to tell them apart, at least for the couple of hours that we had to test them. To back content consumption, Huawei claims wireless audio improvements with the new HWA protocol that they have that brings Bluetooth audio quality to a crazy 990 kilobits in bandwidth. Yes, EMUI is also powering both devices, now version 8.1 that's on top of Android 8.1. Same skin that most of you don't really praise, but all the optimizations that make the experience faster and more fluid than some of its competitors. The company also claims that their new face unlock works in just 0.5 seconds, which they claim is twice as fast as Apple's Face ID and the Samsung Galaxy S9's intelligent scan, though this is 2D mapping. But now that all the basics are out the way, let's talk about the main selling point for one of these phones at least, which is the camera. To start, both devices take a step forward in the selfie department with a whopping 24 megapixel sensor across the board. Now, in the case of the primary shooters, again, the P20 is more like the Mate 10 Pro with a 12 megapixel RGB sensor and a 20 megapixel monochrome, though with a sensor size that Huawei claims is 61% larger than the iPhone X and 22% larger than the Galaxy S9. The P20 Pro is something else entirely, and here's where the whole Pro naming scheme comes to life. To begin, this is Leica's first triple camera system. Second, this is the first phone I've heard of that has a temperature sensor to detect white balance, and it also complements the laser transmitter and laser receiver for autofocusing purposes. Third, the secondary cameras are of the 20 megapixel monochrome sensor at f1.6 aperture and an 8 megapixel telephoto lens at f2.4 aperture with OIS. This primary RGB shooter is of 40 megapixels at f1.8, which is pretty much Nokia PureView territory from back in the day. Huawei claims that this sensor is 223% larger than the iPhone X and 170% larger than the Galaxy S9. All this combo is capable of 3x optical zoom and 5x hybrid zoom, and there's even super slow-mo features at 960 frames per second at 720p, just like certain competitors. Now, Huawei made a big deal of its new AI capabilities, which include detection of 19 subjects automatically, and there's even a new AIS, meaning Artificial Intelligence Stabilization, which the company claims to be superior to OIS, so much so that the primary lens doesn't include that. So yes, all this that I just mentioned is the Huawei P20 Pro, which is pretty much a device on a class of its own when it comes to at least the specifications of its camera, and with the P20 being a more conservative alternative. Whether these devices deliver on all the spec sheet is something that we'll have to prove once these devices arrive at the Pocket Now Labs for review, and that's going to be coming very soon. While that happens, make sure you follow us on social media and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. You can follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera, on Instagram at Jaime Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I'm Jaime Rivera. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next one.